With increasing difficulty in handling herbicide-resistant weeds, Nebraska Extension researchers are looking at cover crops as a potential control option. Supporters of cover crops already favor their use for things like capturing nitrogen, controlling water, and improving soil health. At this year's Soybean Management Field Day in North Platte, Nebraska Extension's Rodrigo Worley discussed the possibility of planting shorter-season soybean varieties as a way to get a cover crop in the ground earlier. We talked with Rodrigo at the event and began by asking about a survey he conducted earlier this year to find out more about how Nebraska farmers were using cover crops.
Yeah, so that's right, Jeff. Earlier this year, I conducted a cover crop survey at the cover crop conference at the former ARDC near Mead. Most folks that were there were folks that, you know, are already doing cover crops. It was a good opportunity for me to understand how they are doing it, how they are incorporating cover crops in their different cropping systems, and what they are observing. So one of the main, you know, the first question that I had for them, what have been the benefits associated with cover crops? And the number one by far was erosion control, wind and water erosion control. So that's a tremendous benefit of cover crops there that we're all aware of. The second one, which was a little surprising, is weed suppression. Folks are noticing that including cover crops as part of their cropping systems have actually improved their overall weed management program. A follow-up question that I had to them, you know, what percentage of producers have noticed improved weed management, and 93% of them have actually noticed that, which is pretty surprising to me.
Yeah, tell me more about that. What kind of weeds are you suppressing and why is it working so well?
Yeah, so as a follow-up question, I asked them, what kind of weeds, you know, are you seeing suppression in your system? And the winter annual weeds were the number one, okay? So your Maristales, your Hembets, and so on, those are pretty much, they pretty much kind of go away when you incorporate, especially cereal rye as a cover crop in the fall. And then some have also noticed reduction in early season weeds, such as the ragweeds and your kochias, which kind of makes sense. And about 30% of the survey participants have also reported they saw some reduction in the overall pigweed pressure on their farms, you know, and we've been struggling with all these weed species, and any type of suppression you can see out there is going to help you tremendously with your overall weed management program.
You're starting a program here to try to determine if a shorter season soybean variety would allow you to get a cover crop in. Describe the research.
That's absolutely right. So we're working with a different group of researchers, in Lincoln and across the state. We also have researchers in Kentucky and Ohio doing that work. So basically what we're looking at is trying to see whether we can go shorter maturity groups in our soybeans, not have too big of a yield hit, yet give the cover crops a little, you know, more chance to grow in the fall. So the idea is, can we harvest a little sooner if we go with a shorter maturity group, get those cover crops in, and see all the benefits we expect with them without hurting the overall productivity of your system?
Yeah, what are the challenges that you could foresee there?
There's several challenges. Depends on what part of the state you're at. If you're further west, water becomes your biggest concern. You know, I'm going to grow a cover crop. It's going to take water away. So that's a challenge. You know, as you go further east, some of the challenges that producers, you know, made us aware is like timing, having the time to drill the cover crop and, you know, picking the right cover crop, combining cover crops with herbicide programs. So those are the biggest challenges. And then during the soybean, just kind of changing topics a little bit here, but during this field days, you know, going back to cover crops, our idea here is to try to provide canopy, you know, for as long as possible throughout your growing season, because your best weed management program is canopy. Herbicides, they help us get there. So, you know, this is just a concept, you know, trying to go a little bit away from the herbicides. We've had several issues with resistance. The toolbox, you know, there aren't as many options in there anymore. So we're trying to diversify the system, perhaps add a little more diversity there, which not only helps with, you know, your weeds, but your overall system.
Kind of in that same arena, how important is termination in selecting which chemicals you're going to use for cover crop termination?
So that's a really good question. Termination is a crucial component of having cover crops. You got to terminate that cover crop at the right time. Especially if you're talking corn, you want to make sure you terminate that a little earlier. So then there is no, you know, nitrogen tie up and all that kind of stuff that might hurt the development, the early season development of your corn. For the soybeans, you can pretty much, you know, green plant them and terminate that, or you can green plant and terminate that at the time of planting. One thing that we recommend producers, if they do that, add the residual and watch the weather, because once you have a residual activity in there, you want to make sure there's water that's going to bring that chemistry down to the ground and get it activated.